Greetings, friends. Let's talk about the View Options menu in Adobe Lightroom Classic. View Options is a powerful, yet often overlooked, part of the user interface. While this part of the program may be old news for longtime Classic users, this tutorial is essential for anyone who's new to the program. And hopefully, I have a few secrets to share here, even with my most experienced viewers. Let's jump right into my Lightroom catalog, and let's get started. Let's begin with some vocabulary. Here in the library module, the images that you see in the grid view are called thumbnails. The area around each thumbnail, this gray space, this is called the cell. Within each cell, you can choose to display a wide variety of information, such as the file name, star rating, colored label, or the flag status. To control these features, we need to open the View Options menu. Now, I'm not going to cover every single setting in here, but I want to highlight the ones that I find most useful. Starting at the top, I'm going to enable the Show Grid Extras, and then I'll set this to the Compact Cells option. This is probably obvious, but as you make changes in this View Options menu, you'll see the results in real time out there on the grid. Next, I'll turn off the Show Clickable Items on Mouse Over Only, because that option is pointless and especially cruel for beginners. I like to turn on the Tint Grid Cells with Label Colors option. And then I usually set this to about 30%. I do this because I use the colored labels to mark the status of my images. I use red for a photo that needs work, yellow for work in progress, and green for my finished products. Likewise, I use the pick and reject flags during my image culling routine. If you're curious, I have an in-depth tutorial where I talk at length about how I cull through my images using a series of smart collections and the pick or reject flags feature. I'm not going to rehash that whole video, but the reject flag in particular is tremendously useful because it allows you to mark images for deletion without immediately sending them to the trash. If you choose to hide these tools away here in the View Options menu, then this fantastic culling tool loses some of its utility. Another useful feature is the ability to show thumbnail badges. These small icons are like merit badges or awards that your images earn as you complete various steps in Lightroom Classic. Badges provide quick, at-a-glance information about what work you have done to each image. Let's close the View Options menu for a moment so I can show you a few examples. This first badge, this is the keywords tags symbol. It appears whenever you've added keywords onto an image. This badge is the develop changes marker. When I see this badge over one of my thumbnails, then I know that I have done something to this image using Lightroom's develop tools. This badge does not tell me whether I've done good work or bad work in the develop module, but it instantly lets me know whether I'm looking at an unedited or an edited raw image. Just so you know, this badge indicates that an image has been cropped, and this one indicates that one of the AI tools, like denoise, raw details, or super resolution, has been applied to this image. Finally, the collections badge indicates if a photo is part of a collection. It's important to note that these badges can also be configured so that they are clickable buttons. If I click on the Develop badge, for example, then Lightroom will take this image into the Develop module so that I can see the changes that I've made to this photograph, and I could make additional changes if needed. Let's open the View Options menu up again, but a quicker way to get there is by right-clicking on any thumbnail and choosing View Options from the bottom of the flyout menu. Moving down to the Compact Cells Extra section, I'm going to enable both the top and bottom label options. These boxes control the text that you see above and below each thumbnail. Right now, my bottom label is set to the Rating and Label option, which is why you see a star rating and a tiny colored label box under some of these images. If you don't use colored labels, then you could consider changing this one to just the star rating choice. While rating and label is my usual configuration, there are times when it helps to see something else below each thumbnail. If you own more than one camera, for example, then there might be a time when it makes sense to switch to the camera model option. In other cases, like when I'm preparing photography lectures, it makes sense to use the focal length option instead. The point that I'm trying to make is that the text above and below each thumbnail can be adjusted to show the information that you need most at this moment. While we're on this topic, let's say that you're working on a project that requires even more detail. To see additional information, go back up to the Show Grid Extras box and switch to the Expanded Cell option. While the Compact Cell allows for two lines of information, the Expanded Cell lets you pick up to four types above and below each image, plus the star rating and colored label at the bottom. In here, I often set things up this way. The expanded cell is perfect for projects where you need a lot of information right at your fingertips. Now that you know what the View Options menu can do, I want to teach you a quick trick that's both a blessing and a curse. The Adobe UI designers made it easy for us to switch between the compact and expanded cell views without needing to open up the whole View Options screen again and again. To change which type of cell we see, they chose the letter J on an English keyboard as the shortcut. When you press the J key, your screen will cycle from the compact view to the expanded cell view. But if you press this key a second time, then you will enter a minimalist display mode where all information is turned off. No file names, ratings, or badges. This can be super frustrating when it's not what you're expecting to see. Even worse, my badges and star ratings appear to have vanished too, and even restarting Lightroom at this moment would not automatically solve this frustration. If this happens to you, don't panic. Just press the J key on your keyboard again to cycle back through the cell view display modes. I can't tell you how many users have contacted me in a panic because all of their grid view information seemed to vanish for no reason. Anyway, now that you know the secret of the J key, this pitfall won't catch you. Oh, one more tip. There is a random option at the very bottom of the View Options menu called Mirror Image Mode. If you turn this one on, then Classic will temporarily rotate all of your thumbnails 180 degrees. This option is not permanent. You've not flipped all your images over. And this one, fortunately, reverts back to normal as soon as you leave the grid view. But it's another one of those little gotchas that can cause a panic when it's accidentally invoked. If you've made it this far, then there's one more thing to show you. The thumbnails in the film strip at the bottom of the screen are also customizable. We don't have as many options down here, but before we adjust anything, let's make sure that your film strip thumbnails are fairly tall. You can drag from this line at the top of the film strip to change their size. When your film strip thumbnails are large enough, their cells can display flags, star ratings, and badges. You would think that you adjust what you see down here from the View Options menu too, but for some inexplicable reason, that is not true. To find the controls for these features, open up Classic's Preference menu. On a Mac, you'll find preferences under the words Lightroom Classic at the far left of the menu bar. On Windows, you'll find preferences inside of the Edit menu. Once you get to the preferences, go over to the Interface tab and look down here at this Film Strip section. Here, I like to enable the Show Badges option. I like to include the Show Rating and Pick Flags option. I like Show Stat Counts, but I usually turn off these others, especially the Ignore Clicks on Badges option. I like to turn that one off so that I can click on these buttons, just like I would in the grid, to make something happen. Anyway, once you've adjusted things to your liking in here, you can close the preferences menu. And now your Filmstrip thumbnails will have the same settings, or close to the same settings, that you have up here in the grid view. Well, there you go. Whether you prefer a minimalist view or a detailed one, the View Options menu gives you the flexibility to customize your Lightroom Classic workspace to suit your specific needs. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please leave us a like or a comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.